dear students, welcome back to my YouTube channel Remedial Classes on English. I'll be providing all the chapters of English and alternative English covering the first year of the year. Please, if you like it, please watch up to the last and then subscribe it and share it. Okay. So today I shall start with the last lesson. Okay. Here I have written. Can you see the last lesson? The last lesson by Alphonse Daudet. Okay, so Alphonse Daudet, he was a French writer, and this story was set in the days when there was a Franco-Prussian war. Okay, French and Prussia, there was a war, and French was defeated. Okay, and then French was defeated. The war was led by Bismarck. The war was led by Bismarck. Okay, this much. And now let's start the story. Okay, the last lesson. The last lesson here, you know, there is a very important theme here. Here it talks about the loss of one's language. You know, language is the key to prison. If one doesn't have language, it becomes so much problematic in this world. Because once you lost your language, you become enslaved. Okay. So here you see, suppose you are reading English every day. Now people are suppose in the English medium students of HS second year, and suddenly, you know, if you hear that from tomorrow there will be no English classes, you have to totally only learn in read and write in Sanskrit, how do you feel? Just imagine. So the same case is here with the story. Here the story is that from the next day, the French language will not be taught in the schools. Only German would be taught, because the Prussians, they have already won. They have defeated French. So the story starts with a small boy. He is a school boy. His name is Franz. The name of the boy is Franz. Okay, F-R-A-N-Z. Or let me write some of the things so that you can remember it very well. The name of the boy is Franz. F-R-A-N-Z. F-R-A-N-Z. And this boy, he does not like to go to school. You know, he is always, he likes to see the birds, you know, outside the sky. He wants to enjoy the time watching the bird's nest and that sliding in the river Saar. Here the river Saar is very much clearly mentioned. Okay, S-A-A-R. The name of the river is S-A-A-R, Saar. Okay, so on that day, on that particular day also, Franz was very late. He didn't want to go to school because the teacher was M. Hamel, the headmaster of the school, and the teacher said that today I will be questioning on participles. And this boy Franz, he did not know the first word about them. So he was not interested in going to school. He was thinking that I would not go to school. But suddenly something happened to him, and he said that he was walking around here and there, seeing the Prussian soldiers drilling, and then he was watching the bird's nest, this and that. And then suddenly he thought that, no, let me go to school. But he suddenly thought of going to school, and he ran towards the school. And while he was running, you know, he saw there was a bulletin board. Okay, so in the bulletin board, I mean, every time some report comes, and on that day also he saw that there were crowds of people standing there and then looking at the board. And so he was thinking that what might have happened. You know, since last 2 years we are hearing all the loss of battles and war and all, so what might be today? So he didn't much notice. He was running towards the school. At that time there was a man called Wachter, W-A-C-H-T-E-R. Okay, W-A-C-H-T-E-R, Wachter. He was the blacksmith. And then this blacksmith, he said, don't go fast, boy. This line is very important. The Wachter said that don't go fast, boy. You will reach in school in plenty of time. Okay, but then, the Wachter said that you don't have to go so fast. You will reach in school in time. But then Franz did not notice about all this. He just ran to the school. And when he reached the school, you know, that day, the school was in a very strange position. It was very silent. And, you know, he was walking think so, because the other teacher, M. Hamel, he is a very strict one, and he scolds and he is a cranky also. So the friend was a bit afraid that I am late today. But then, you know, when usually means when the school opens, during the school days, you know, there would be noises of benches and desks moving around. Means students get inside the benches and desks, so they will move the bench. There will be sounds of bench and desks moving, and then the teacher walking up and down with his big ruler, okay, and then hammering the ruler on the some table. And so that day everything was silent. It was like Sunday morning, as if there was no school. You know, on Sundays you see in the schools and institutions they remain so silent. In this way the school was totally silent. So he suddenly reached the school, and then he saw through the window that what happened, all his classmates were seated in their places. And then the most strange thing was that what happened, he saw that the back benches which were usually blank, nobody sits there, it was vacate. But on that day the village people, they also came and sat down there. So it was shocking for Franz what happened. And then the teacher, he did not scold him, he said that, "Franz, we were beginning without you, so please come and get inside the class." So Franz, you know, he quickly came and sat down in the place, okay. Then suddenly when he looked up to his teacher, he found that the teacher, he was wearing his the special dress which he never wore, okay. Only he wore on any inspection days or prize days or any special occasions, otherwise he doesn't wear that dress. So that day the teacher was wearing that that dress, okay. It was like a silk cap, all embroidered, frilled shirt, okay, green coat. So this Franz, he was shocked. He was saying, "Why is sir wearing like this, and why these people are sitting at the back benches, which remains empty most of the time, and why they're sitting?" Then suddenly M. Hamel, he mounted on the chair, and then he said, "Students, this is your last French lesson. The order has come from Berlin that from tomorrow only Germany would be taught in the schools of Alsace and Lorraine." Okay, the story is basically Alsace and Lorraine is described. These are the border districts of France, okay, border districts of France. It is very near to the Germany. So the Germany will be, we have already invaded, they have won, they have defeated the French, and then Germany will occupy. And from next day, no French language would be taught in the schools, only German. So this news had totally, it was like a thunderclap to Franz. Means it was very shocking to Franz, you know. And suddenly he thought that, oh my God, he forgot that how cranky his teacher was. He felt sorry for his the teacher who had dedicated his service for a period of about 40 years. He has been teaching in that school for 40 years, okay. Franz was feeling very sorry. Then the teacher was calling students one by one. You know, the M. Hamel was teaching every classes, and he was with patience, he was listening to all the students. And then now the time came for Franz. And will Franz, the fellow who never studies, will he be able to understand, will he be able to answer? You know, on the first line only he got jumbled up, he could not answer anything. Then M. Hamel said that, "Franz, you are not to be blamed only. You are not to be blamed only. We all are responsible for what is happening today, because the people, your parents were never anxious. They never sent you to school. They wanted you to help them in their work. And even the M. Hamel, he said that he was to be also blamed, because he said that when, you know, instead of making you learn your lessons, I sometimes sent you to water the garden. You know, he has a garden and water the garden. Moreover, during when I want to go for fishing, you know, I gave a holiday." So the M. Hamel was saying that that is the fault with all the people. And also he was saying that the French people, they have the thought that they put their work till tomorrow. Means tomorrow I will do, they say. So this is the main reason that today a day has come when we have to lose our language, okay, and then the Germany will be taught. So Now then M. Hamel talked about the French language. He said it was the most beautiful language in the world, most logical, okay, most clear language in the world. And then he taught the people and to all the people one should guard one's language, otherwise it becomes very difficult, okay. So he was telling that, look how it is that we have said that we shall do it tomorrow, and today, you know, what we have come up, what will the Germanic say to you, that you don't know even your language and you are claiming that you are French. So in this way, headmaster was talking like that, okay. Then what happened, he had circulated all these small notes with a cursive writing, okay, in a cursive round hand. It was written Alsace France in the notebook, and these notebooks were fluttering all over the classroom, just like, you know, it was very like small flags. It was looking very beautiful, and then the headmaster was teaching very well. And then on that day, when Franz was thinking that, oh my god, how well I'm understanding today, because on that day, because the thought that the teacher would go away, and the thought that the books which he carried all day, this his grammar books and history books were his friends, and then now he will not be bringing those books anymore, that made him feel so sad. That and he was deeply listening to what sir was saying. It seemed that sir was also trying to give them whatever he knew, and that it seemed that Franz was also understanding whatever sir was teaching, okay. Then what happened, in this way all the classes, then the small babies, they chanted their ba baby bo boo like that. Everybody, they were reading from the first to the last class. Suddenly, you know, the clock struck 12. As soon as the church clock struck 12, you know, the soldiers who were drilling and marching, they were entering into their country. You know, it was so sad, like things with drums and beatings and all. You know, the sound was profoundly, it was hard, it was getting more and more prompt, the sound was too high, and the drilling soldiers were getting inside the French. So the thing was very sad. And then this M. Hamel, he could not anymore, his voice got choked, he could not speak more, okay. And then suddenly he somehow managed to, he was a tall man, so somehow he managed to stand, okay. He was feeling like, because he has to also leave the country no longer for 40 years, he has served in that country, and the people also, French was realizing that why these people came and sat at the back benches, all the mayor of the village, then the old hussar and all of them. And why did they come? Because they also came to pay tribute to M. Hamel, who had been in their country and had been teaching French for a period of 40 years. And then, and also they also came to pay tribute to their own language, which they have never cared for. So it was the last day they came to honor the teacher as well as to honor their language. That is why they have attended the class. So all these things, Franz was feeling very sad. And suddenly what happened, M. Hamel, as soon as the church clock struck 12, he rose with all his strength. His voice was choking, and then he could not stand, but somehow he stood and wrote, and on the blackboard in a very big word, Vive la France. Vive la France. Vive la France means, you know, long live France. I will write the Vive la France here so that you can, this is a very important line. Important line, so Vive la France. V-I-V-E, Vive la France. F-R-A-N-C-E. That means long live France. Vive la France means long live France. And then the story ended in this place. Without making any voice, the teacher just made a gesture that you can go. This was the end of the story. Okay, so from this story, what have you learned, students? From this story, we learned that language is the key. Okay, one should try to keep their language intact. One should try to speak one's language, try to keep it. You know, the more your language is flourished, the more developed you are. So this is the end of the class. If you liked my class, please subscribe it and share it with your friends, okay. And you will get all the updates. I'll be keeping on updating the stories of HS first year and second year, covering both alternative English and English, and also this one, both CBSE and SEBA, okay. Okay, thank you.